speaking with William Johnson this morning from Lithium Energy. William, good morning.
Andrew, good morning. How are you?
Yeah, very well, William. A bit of an update from you this week here on the scoping study and these different potential development pathways for the Solaroz lithium brine projects. Tell us a bit more about what you're assessing, what you're looking at.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks, Andrew. So we've been working with engineering firm Hatch for a few months now. And essentially the task we gave them was to help us work out the best way of developing the Solaroz lithium brine project, which, you know, to remind your listeners, we're located in the heart of South America's Lithium Triangle in Argentina, on one of the most well-known salt lakes there being the Olaroz Salar, which is where other sort of lithium majors, Allkem and Lithium Americas, are currently producing lithium from. Based upon the work done to date, you know, we're really pleased and have just released an announcement that confirms that the work done by Hatch confirms that the brine we have in terms of the chemistry and the grades are definitely ideally suited for the use of conventional brine evaporation, which is what's most commonly used in the Lithium Triangle in South America for producing high-grade or battery-grade lithium carbonate from these brines. So that's really positive news for us. It significantly de-risks the project from a technical perspective, because that's the same conventional brine, conventional pond evaporation technology that our neighbors Allkem and Lithium Americas are using. So we can essentially look at their operations as, if you like, sort of pilot plants to help us now sort of, I guess, design the forward pathway for the project. However, in addition, I mean, Hatch also confirmed that we should also continue to look at the alternative newer technologies, the direct lithium extraction, which is a way of extracting lithium from brines without the need for the constructing the ponds. So that gives us an alternative development pathway. And basically it means we can be essentially technology agnostic in terms of how this project advances, which is a real benefit for projects in this part of the world.
And so, William, how's work on the full scoping study going?
Yeah, well, look, it's drawing to a conclusion now, Andrew, and what we're sort of planning now is the next step. So the next step from the scoping study is to then move directly into feasibility studies. And the first part of those, I guess, the next study work will be now looking at these options, conventional pond evaporation, DLE, determining what is the preferred pathway, the development timetable, and to what extent we look at staging the development, perhaps starting off with a relatively, you know, smaller plant first, maybe 10 or 15,000 tons per annum, and then scaling up, or going directly to larger 20 or 40,000 ton per annum operations, which is the scale that our neighbours are currently operating at Olaroz.
I suppose, William, what more can you tell us about these approaches that you've had by groups active in the EV space?
Yes, well, look, I mean, we've believed for some time that the Solaroz project is very strategic, given its location. You know, it's large scale, high quality, and located right next door to, you know, to the existing major players in Argentina. So that sort of put us on the radar of, you know, a number of sort of fairly large players in the EV space. And these are companies that are looking to lock in long-term strategic supplies of, you know, of lithium for the next 20, 30, 40 years. And there's been a lot of M&A activity in the space in the last year. You know, what I can say is we've been talking to a number of these parties who are very, very interested, have been looking very closely at the project. You know, we are considering maybe inviting one or more of these parties to participate in the project going forward. I mean, you know, building a large scale lithium production facility costs a lot of money. You know, we're certainly considering the option of having one of these parties joining to assist us in advancing the project, you know, by not just providing capital, but also other sort of resources and expertise and so forth. So, you know, we're working through a process with a number of parties. And, you know, if we get to a stage with one or more, where we you know, getting pretty serious, then we'll certainly update the market.
Good to speak, William. Thanks for your time.
Great. Thanks, Andrew. Bye for now.